We have so many people employed by the devil to push us down, to make sure that our life remains the same, to make sure that whatever that we are struggling for in life will become nothing. I hope you are here tonight. If you are here, let me hear your amen. Listen to this revelation, child of God.
Is that what that's saying?
Who pushed you is talking about someone who has decided to bring your life to
together.
But if you are here today, because of the grace of this house, who has pushed you in life? Anybody that has pushed you in life? It's rather helping you so that you can accomplish even what you are afraid of. Let me tell you a short story about a very rich and wealthy man. He was fucking ghosted.
No, you be our one.
He had many servants. A big house. Many mansions. Many properties.
And
he had only one daughter. And one day, he said to himself, how can I know? Who really and truly loves my daughter? So what should I do? So the man gathered all the people around that town. Those who are interested in her daughter. And then he told them, if you want to marry my daughter, there is only one task. That I want each and every one of you to do. If you are able to do it and you do it
successfully,
I will reward you. It's not that I will give you my daughter. I will give you my property. I will give you money. You will not suffer in life anymore. As soon as the men heard this news, they said to themselves, I am the one who is going to win. The one said to the other, I am the one who is going to win. Whether this man likes it or not. That day, they all gathered in the man's house. And when they did the gathering,
now,
one strange thing happened. The man took the 10 men to
the bullseye.
And when he went away there, he told them, there are crocodiles in this water. I want you that
boat.
And you would want to marry my daughter and also inherit my property. I want that person to be the first person to fall into the water. And immediately the man made that annoying announcement. The whole place was silent. Everybody was quiet. There was none who was willing to go into the water, that is full of
crocodiles.
And one thing happened. Immediately, one said to himself, I have to leave here with Ali.
I was sending you out.
He started running away. And of course, he left. And that person said, I have to also leave here. I can't call you to this water. I have to sleep here and go. He also left. They were left with 8 people. Just as they were around the
pool.
Among the 8 were 2 close friends. Best friends. One looked at the friend and said, as for you, your family is too poor. So you are the one who
did
this. So you have to go and get him. And the guy said, no, I can't do that. Immediately, before he can even say no, the so-called best friend, the so-called close friend, into the pool. When he was going inside the deep water, he was screaming for him. Everybody left the place. It was left with the man and the daughter. The man was looking at him in the pool. And he ordered his voice to come and remove him out. And when they took him out of the water, the man said to him, are you not surprised that the crocodiles in the water were not able to harm you? The guy said, I'm surprised. And the man suddenly said, you have proved your goodness by falling into the water. In spite of seeing the crocodiles, you still fell into that same water. And for that reason, I am giving you my daughter to marry. And also all my properties. The guy suddenly turned and looked at the man. And then look at the eight that has went far away. And he loudly asked, who pushed me? The one who pushed me has given me courage. It is because of those hidden enemies. It is because of those bandits that have made us strong today. If you want to be strong in life, that was a time I told you, nobody found strong. We learn to be strong. And because we learn to be strong, they don't know that they are pushing us for our platform. Something happened in the Bible.
This is our Bible no more.
According to 2 Samuel.
Yes. Some woman, I just mean.
Chapter 6, verse 9.
It's very simple.
It speaks about a man called Obedon. Now, this is what happened to that man. Israelites rebelled against God. And God left them in the hands of their enemies. Those were Philistines. And they captured the ark of God. The ark of God. And when they captured that ark on the covenant, this is what happened.
Yes.
God decided to strike that nation with illness.
And he strengthened
a very severe illness.
Until
it got to a time. And he got to realize. No, this is not normal. It is because of the act of the covenant. That is why all these illness has come over us. So we need to repent. And let me tell you the meaning of the act of the covenant. The act of the covenant means the Lord God of hosts. It means that the army commander of the Lord's army. Let me explain it for you to understand. The army commander of the heavens. The ark has been captured.
Amen.
And they have to return it. And they cannot return it just like that. They have to add a piece of weight onto
it.
And they decided to do that. And when they did that, even they were not able to send the ark into the
Jerusalem.
They went and hid it in a man's house. When the ark was in Abinadab's house,
he stayed
there for 20 years. Unmoved, nobody was able to touch him. Until 30 years, he came again. And then he built the city of David. And he decided that I have to go and bring the ark of the covenant.
No, yeah, no, yes, I was up for Father David.
Do you understand the ark of the covenant?
I don't want to say,
it is an object of the spirit. When it is with you, you don't go to war to defeat. No matter the wicked in your house, your God will give you victory. His spirit lives in the boss. So David decided that he was going to bring the boss. And when he got there, he gathered over 30,000 men.
30,000.
And when he gathered them, they went there. He took two people. You know the ark of the covenant. It was on a hill. And that people, you know the olden times, the one that the donkeys
used.
So two people have to write it. And the first person who wrote it was Uzzah. And the second person was Oyin. And this is what happened. Just as they took the ark of the covenant, and they were heading back to the city of David, where they had decided to place it there. With the 30,000 men singing and dancing. Out of nowhere, the ark started to fall. And then it started shifting. So one of those who were riding the horse decided to hold it so that the ark would not fall. Immediately, and then David became terrified. And he decided that.
So
then they had to leave the ark there. And when they decided to leave the ark there, a man obedido.
I've been obedido.
To the heart.
Of Fasada Kenji.
And then placed it in his house. And when the ark was with him, for 3 months, just 3 months, his life started changing. He started prospering. His family started seeing the glory of God. And then someone went and informed him. The ark that he left. The ark that he abandoned. The ark that he wanted to kill for Benito. And destroy all his household. That ark did not destroy Benito. It never killed him. In fact, his daughters are getting married. The Bible says, immediately that he heard that,
and Jamsi
he decided that he's then going to take the ark.
Into a yasa baba kofada kai.
Let's get this here.
Yanti sasa nyasi ye.
Who pushed you?
Why and a war with you?
He left the ark in the house of Obedio.
Ujada karu Obedio.
Thinking that it was going to destroy you. Anyone who is thinking to destroy you. God is not like them. They themselves will be destroyed. And they will be punished. In their own place. Come on, sound
sound. My heart. Me a bring in our. Thank you.
Sometimes you say uniform, how much is the uniform? No, can you say the worker man? But I'm not a man who knows that. I'm a brown man. The council has been made for my man. My father's been almost the same thing. No, I say I am. And so the man made me change you. See, I won't buy a son. No, so they're going to show you easy. So maybe I'm around with them about my own living issue. Most people are not good reason. Mom, brother, from a bad thing. Never be free, they're close to my friend. They are treasures. And I may buy a mark, I say. Be best with the rain. Maybe. Now, you see, your man. Now, my own pay a man. Most people are not mature. No, my friend, master, my virtue. I'm a child, I'm a child, I'm a past thing. You see, I will make one pay a thing. You are the phones, I'm saying. You be me. Vai como se vive, não tem mais que me ajude. Se me dá um pouco de café, eu vou tirar minha mão. O demônio me toma um braço, um braço. Vai tirar minha mão. Se ele achou ele, não sei se ele achou ele. Mas está a ver, eu estou a ver. O que isso? Ei, a ver. Não sei, eu me dei a minha mão. O mar acaba. Eu me disse, vamos tudo dar sua vida. Se não, não vai entender. Mas não, para não ver, eu estou a ver.
Overcoming.
No stress.
Overcoming.
No stress.
For faith in.